5, 4, 3, 2. Hey, welcome to the One Dive at a Time podcast. I am your host in convalescence, Rob Anderson. I'm the founder and director of Neptune Warrior, where our mission is healing heroes one dive at a time. I am doing this podcast outside today just because I need a little bit of sunshine. I'm in convalescence right now. Had a surgery on Tuesday. Not going to share the details of what that was, but I can't guarantee I will have a full return to diving in just a couple of weeks. Actually had a few complications, had to wind up back in the emergency room 2 days after the surgery. And as you can tell, throat is a little raspy. You know, I had a air tube shoved down my throat, all that kind of stuff. But I'm back. I'm not back to diving, but I'm back on the podcast. And I just felt like I need, sitting around the house, and I'm one of those guys that does a lot of stuff. I've always got something going on. Sitting around the house is not in my wheelhouse. And yet I know I can't push myself too hard. Otherwise, I'm not going to recover well. So anyway, I thought, well, let's go sit outside. And then I was sitting here looking at the Zoom PodTrack P4, which is what I do all my podcasting on. Or now do all my podcasting on. So glad I went back to the P4. And thought, why not? Let's whip out the mic and knock out a podcast just to kind of do a quick check-in. I know all six of you out there are concerned about what's going on. That's the six subscribers. Had an awesome weekend, or an awesome Monday, I guess I should say, with the Purple Heart dive. And I want to thank everybody who showed up for that. And I especially want to thank Matt for doing all the setup and really looking out for the divers and doing all the many great things that he does. Guy's become such a fantastic instructor. Then also Dave for helping to set up. Want to wish Jack a happy birthday because his birthday happens to be on Memorial Day, or this year fell on Memorial Day. And of course, we've got some new divers out there. And also, check this out. Our Master Scuba Diver candidates did their quint swim. Now, that's about a 1,000-yard swim, give or take. And that's a swim over and back. And it's just part of the criteria that we have for Master Scuba Diver. And that's really what I want to talk about in this episode, is the Neptune Warrior Master Scuba Diver Certification. Now, if you go out to NAWI, or if you go out to SEI, both have Master Scuba Diver courses that you can go through. SEI actually splits us up between 1 and 4 levels. NAWI has a Master Scuba Diver level. And it includes things like deep diving, simulated decompression diving, limited vis, night diving, environmental studies, all these different things that you can do. Back in 2017, I wanted to set ours apart. And actually, ours broke up into two categories. One started out as the Master Scuba Diver course, but it had to be attainable because I was still doing it for a few shops as a contractor, and it had to be attainable. But I also wanted to make sure that when somebody got that certification, they felt like that they had really, really earned something. And the first program that I created was, it was highly, highly demanding. So much so that it became almost unattainable for some folks. And that is what wound up becoming the badass diver. Now, I've talked about that on previous podcasts. Not going to mention or not going to really talk about it today because I do want to focus on what we have set up as our Master Scuba Diver program. Now, both with SCI, Scuba Educators International, as well as NAWI, National Association of Underwater Instructors, as an instructor, I can change but not take away from the requirements. So what I set out to do was build something that was not a typical Master Scuba Diver course. And I wanted something that was going to make complete divers, confident divers, competent divers. Everyone who has gone through this program with Neptune and they've gone on into the professional ranks, they all say that this was a great basis for building into those other areas. And even those who didn't go into professional ranks that have finished this Master Scuba Diver program as they've gone into things like technical diving or they've picked up other disciplines like side mount. We have someone who's now designing or working towards designing their own gear for production. All of this was a basis for that. So let me talk about the program. I'm going to go through the prereqs and then go through the different parts of the program. Now, by the way, the two places where you can find this is out on scubarob.com. Also, theneptunewarrior.com. So still trying to get that site set up. If you clear out your cookie cache or go incognito and you've gone to the Scuba Rob in the past, you should have no problems with going to theneptunewarrior.com. And that site looks totally different now. Of course, if you used to go there by scubarob.com for a little while, that site's still going to work. So that whole list is out there. So here's the prerequisites. Let me go and start out with the prerequisites. First of all, 25 dives. That doesn't sound like a lot of prerequisites to get into this program. But by the time that you finish it, you will have more diving than you had really expected to have. So prereqs, 25 dives. You have to have your advanced diver or approved equivalent experience. And that experience needs to include deep, navigation, night, as well as competent diving skills. Again, these are the prereqs. You also have to have your rescue scuba diver. However, you can complete that as part of this course. Academic requirements. So we are using the NAWI Master Scuba Diver online training as part of that academic requirement. I really like that the way that format is. That's not to take anything away from SEI. I really just like how my participants can go through the NAWI work, and then we can supplement that with classroom lectures and discussions. There's also 10 to 16 hours of in-class activities, and that might be going through things that are in either one of those Master Scuba Diver programs. It could also include projects that we do. It could include open discussions. It could include forums. It can also include going to different classes. So let's say that you decide that you want to do a scientific diver course or a citizen scientific diver course. That would count towards those 10 to 16 hours. A completed journal with dives. And that also needs to hold your experiments and your projects. And I'm really big on journaling. And I've got several YouTube videos out there on how to do the journals. Then there's also required reading. There's quite a bit of reading that goes along with this. But again, becoming a competent, knowledgeable diver, you've got to get some other academics behind you. And so first of all, Scuba Confidential by Simon Pridemore, Blue Mind by Wallace J. Nichols, Surviving Survival by Lawrence Gonzalez. And then there's also a book, because we are a veteran organization, it's called Once a Warrior. And it's about working with veterans or being a veteran who is going through that transition process, might be dealing with PTSD, anxiety. I want anyone that is involved in Neptune to be reading that book. And then also two additional readings that come out of that. All right, as far as dives. So remember, the prereq was 25. Got an airplane going over right now. The prereq was 25 dives, minimum. So you must have the total of 60 dives total at completion. And it breaks down like this. Search and recovery. You have to have four different types of dives, or four search and recovery dives. And they have to include circle searches, semicircle searches, jackline searches, as well as lift and move a heavy object. In navigation, you have to do four navigation dives. A 500-yard course, a night nav course that is point-to-point, a day nav that is long distance, and then a night nav that's long distance. And those day nav and night nav are multiple point distance dives. For night diving, now by the way, none of these dives count. So like, you can't go do a night dive and count it as a night dive and your night long distance. They are separate dives. But for night dive, four night dives. One has to be done on a buddy line. Another dive, you have to go out and set up your shoreline lights. And then you also have to have a total blackout simulation on a night dive. We also have two air consumption dives. One is where you'll do your sac rate dive. And you've also got experiments. And those experiments can be either a free flow experiment or a spare air experiment. And essentially what we do is the diver goes down and they take on the free flow experiment, for example, they will take an additional tank and regulator with them. That regulator is set up to free flow. So this is an addition to their other equipment. And they will have to bail out of that dive using a free flow regulator. The other possibility, or the other option, is that they go down with a spare air regulator or a spare air set, and they will count at depth how many breaths that they actually get out of that. Now, most of my divers actually do both of those experiments. Underwater mapping, 2+ dives. So if it takes you 2 dives to do your underwater mapping of an area such as Quinn's or Blue Lake or wherever it is that you're mapping. If it takes you 2 dives, hey, that's great. Most divers have to take more. 4 deep dives are required. And then we get into, now that's all the required stuff. Then we start to get into the elective and specialty dives. So it's 2 elective specialty dives and 2 dives per specialty. So that's 4. And here's what the options are. Dry suit, digital imagery, training assistant, citizen science diver, side mount, full face mask, nitrox, altitude diver, DPV, ice diver, underwater archaeology, underwater hunting and collecting, wreck, underwater naturalist, boat diving, personal watercraft diver, free diver, and then I've got a couple of instructor specialties such as underwater metal detecting, bottle hounding, a few others, and then also any approved specialty that may not be on the list. So what this does is it really helps to round out the diver with different types of opportunities. Now, honestly, every single one of my master scuba diver candidates has done more than the 2 specialty dives. In fact, quite often what they will do is they will do a dry suit, digital imagery, DPV, underwater naturalist, and then a couple of the instructor specialties that I do. Then we come to an area that's around projects. I like projects because it really shows a diver and their skill level on the dive site. I mean, you've been walking around and you see the way that someone puts their gear together, the way that they store their gear, the way they handle their equipment. They don't look like they're just certified in diving. You look at them and it's like, that dude or that dudette is a diver. And so here's the required projects. And by the way, all these projects feed back into necessity on a dive site, either doing repairs that are not life support type repairs. I mean, we're not talking rebuilding regulators, but maybe fixing a wetsuit or fixing the zipper on a pocket, you know, things like that. So here's the required projects. Number one, glue an affiliation patch to a wetsuit. That can be a Neptune Warrior patch. That can be a Naui patch, an SCI patch, whatever it happens to be, whatever that affiliation is. Glue an affiliation patch to the wetsuit. That teaches them how to use Aqua Seal. It teaches them how to use, you know, to do repairs on neoprene if they need to. Next one is make a lanyard for their lights. And even though we do start this out in the advanced program, it's something we carry on over through Master Scuba Diver. Make a buddy line. Again, we do that in advance, but we carry it over to Master Scuba Diver. Whip and wrap bolt snaps. It gave me a lot of joy this last week. And by the way, the requirement is 4 on here, but sitting there watching Ryan wrap about 10 different bolt snaps. And by the way, that wrapping pays off. So one of our divers, John, one of our, you know, very accomplished diver, tons and tons of dives. And when he was out in Quinn's, he happened to find a bag that had stuff in it, you know, a little collection bag. And on one end of it, it had a dive knife. But what was holding the dive knife and the bag together was a bolt snap. Because on our bolt snaps, we choose our own colors to identify. So like I use a coyote and olive drab for most of my bolt snap wraps. John uses blue and white. Ryan uses infantry blue. John was able to identify that that was his bolt snap that at some point he had loaned to somebody. So again, all these things have got different, you know, they do have a purpose out there. So whipping and wrapping bolt snaps. SMB and finger reel ascent kit. So putting one of those kits together. We teach that skill in advance, but it's important that you have that. You know, we want to make sure that we include that in the Master Scuba Diver experience, mainly so that you get in the habit of carrying it with you. I mean, time and time and time again, we see this being used more and more on ascents. The other one is using a speedy stitch, sew a name on a pack. Then they have to sew 2 ditty bags, again, to keep gear in it. And then finally build a save a dive kit. And then finally a capstone project, which must be approved. So for example, Matt and Ivan and a few others, they put the swimming pool up here for Neptune Warrior. That was their capstone project. I've had other people create, you know, games. I mean, if someone wanted to go out and work with Parks and Rec to put up an information board on what the dive flag means and what the state law is to stay away from. I mean, that could be a project, whatever it happens to be, but there has to be a capstone project and it has to be approved. All right, electives. Pick any three electives. Make a lift bag, building a wrench shower, building a drying rack, make a pony bottle holder, make soft weight, make a set of soft weight pouches, make a dive floating flag, build and donate underwater games for our veterans and Neptune Warrior. Build out a promo or research video and post it online. So I know that one of my divers or one of my candidates right now, Becky, is really looking at doing research on how diving helps those in the geriatric community. So that's one of the things I would look forward to is her promo or her research video and posting that on how scuba diving helps the geriatric community. Building out an anchor bag, building a scuba tank holder, making a hang bar or a safety stop bar, or any other approved electives. So again, those are just projects. And you know, when you walk out onto a dive site and you see someone who has their own rinse shower, or they've got a drying rack that they've bolted onto their Jeep or their vehicle or whatever, or someone's using soft weight pouches that they made, that just sets them apart, right? And by the way, a lot of the folks who have done these skills have carried us over. I mean, there's a group of folks that meet on Tuesday nights over at Matt's place where they're doing things like building back plates and building side mount rigs and building bladders and all kinds of, you know, really cool stuff. Pool skills, going back to a lot of the old basics here, but ditch, surface, dawn, dive, and dawn. So, and that's done inside a 3x3 area. And essentially that means that you take off your scuba gear, take off your back plate and wink, use surface, and then you dive back down, and then you put your gear back on. And it all has to be done within a 3x3 area. That way you're not bouncing across the pool and stuff. Doing underwater knots. There's 4 underwater knots that are required, and those are done on breath hold. Underwater swims, and then a bound hands and feet swim. Obviously done with lifeguards nearby. And they will do both a swim as well as doing a mask recovery. And then open water swims, and that's where I started this podcast at, was talking about the Quinn swim, which is across and back with no time on the surface. That's a mask, fins, and snorkel, and then also doing a cross and back on scuba. So you can find this list again out on scubarob.com. There's a blog posting on it. If you go out into the search engine and just type in Master Scuba Diver, it's going to, you know, on the search on the website itself, it'll bring you up to those requirements. We've set this up so that it makes a highly competent and a highly confident diver. Just feel that that's the way, I mean, again, my philosophy is to make divers and not just certified people in diving. And this is a part of it. Sorry for the raspy voice today. Trying to kind of get through this. Trying to just get myself back and doing things that I feel that are productive again. All right. Remember, hope things are going well. I'll be back into the underwater world in just a couple of weeks here. Like to shout out and thank Brooks a whole lot because she has been by my side on this all the way through. All right. Remember, as long as you've got air, you are all right.